Hello, Async await is stable now. Hooray! So in this next couple of videos, I want to demonstrate writing a small network service using Async await and Tokio 0.2. I wanted to learn the new syntax for myself, so I made an ident server just for fun. It's quite simple, only about 150 lines of code. Now that it works, in these videos I want to build up that server in bite-sized chunks and talk about how it fits together. It didn't go completely smoothly, so I'll point out some gotchas along the way. You may not know what an ident server does, which is because they haven't been used for a very long time. Once upon a time, this was a way to ask a remote computer which user is responsible for a particular network connection. The ident server itself listens on TCP port 113. A client connects and sends a query, which is one line of text. The server processes the query and sends one line of text as a reply, for example, one of these. It's a very simple protocol, which makes it great for a test project. We're not going to get quite this far today, but hopefully you can see where we're going with this. Let's look at some code. Here is the basic structure of a TCP server using Tokio 0.2. This code is directly inspired by the examples in the Tokio project repo. If you're writing your own, you should definitely look at those sample projects. Previously, you had to either use Tokio Run or create a Tokio runtime to get into async land. That's still true, actually, but they have this Tokio main attribute that hides some of the boilerplate when you intend for your entire application to be async. You can now treat your main function as async and start awaiting on things right away. Nice. So the first thing I'm going to do is bind to port 10,113. Really, it's supposed to be port 113, but I don't want to have to run this with super user privileges while I'm developing it. Since it's 2019, I want my ident server to support IPv6, of course, so I'll bind to :: instead of 0.0.0.0. And here we see our first await of the day. While that attempt to bind the port is in progress, rather than blocking the thread, this async task will go to sleep. This doesn't really gain us anything while the application is first starting up. It doesn't have anything else to do anyway, but it's good to know that I can bind more ports asynchronously if I wanted to. Now, this returns a result type because the bind could fail. For example, if somebody was already using the listening port we requested. If it doesn't work, I just want to abort, so I'll use the try operator. Hopefully it was successful though, and we are returned a TCP listener. What are we going to do with our TCP listener? Well, we want to wait for a client to connect. That's going to take a while, so again, this is an operation where we await. This listener task on the Tokio runtime goes to sleep until we either get a new client or the listener itself suffers an error. If there is an error, we again use the try operator to simply abort the program. But normally someone will connect and we'll get a new TCP stream object here in socket. This represents a connection to a newly connected client that we should talk to. So I've started a function down here for handling each individual client. As you can see, it's an async function, which means that its return value is implicitly wrapped in a future, and also that it can await on other things if it wants to. The first thing it will do is print out the IP address of the client who connected. Then it will wait to receive some data from the client and print out what they sent as a UTF-8 string. Now I need to be a bit careful about how I invoke this client handler from the listener. Let's do some experiments. First, I'm going to do the obvious thing. I'm going to await on it and use the try operator. Let's run this. Now that it's running, I'm going to use NC to connect and send some data in. Cool. Seems to be working perfectly. We can see the printouts here. But there are problems. Okay, let's say that I'm a bad client and I send something that isn't actually valid UTF-8. Oops, our server terminated. That's not good. This call to from UTF-8 produced an error because the text wasn't valid UTF-8. Because of this try operator, handle client returned an error. Because of this try operator, our entire listener aborted with an error. This isn't what we want. From the point of view of the listening task, up here, we don't care whether an individual client suffered an error or not. Maybe we'd like to log it, but you know, let's just discard the result instead of propagating it. It could be an okay, or it could be an error, if we don't care. Now let's run it again. Look at that. Now I can send either valid or invalid data, and the server keeps running and accepting new connections. Great. Let's now try something else. Instead of piping in some data from Echo, I'm going to run NC directly, which means it will sit there holding the connection open and I have to type the data that I want to send. Let's start fresh. I run NC, I receive a connection that's waiting for data. Then, in another terminal, I run another connection. But there's no log message for the second connection. In fact, I can send as much data as I like on this second connection and it's not being processed. What gives? Well, it's actually stuck waiting for the first connection to send some data. If I type some data over here, suddenly that unblocks everything and both connections go through. So our second attempt isn't quite right either. Every time we get a new client, we want to make a task that runs concurrently on the Tokio runtime. Just because one client is down here waiting for data doesn't mean that it should block us accepting a new client. So when we handle the client, we don't really want to await at all. We want to take this async future and spawn it as a new and independent task. You do this using Tokio spawn. So let's do that. Tokio spawn the future. It's exactly like spawning a thread. This will disappear into the background immediately, and the listener gets to go back and accept the next connection. So let's try to run that. Unfortunately, this doesn't compile. This text in red is actually kind of backwards. The problem is that Tokio will only spawn a future if it has no output value. Our future is this handle client function. It doesn't return nothing. It returns a result. Therefore, we can't spawn it directly. We can fix this too by wrapping our call inside an async block. This async block doesn't return anything, so it represents a future that has no output value. We should be able to spawn it. Let's try it again. Great, it's compiled and running. Let's try this out again. Oh, now we can't connect at all, and there's no log messages. Maybe you've already spotted my mistake. Let me change this underscore to an unused binding. Remember what I said earlier, that an async function's return value is implicitly wrapped in a future. If we hover over this with RLS, we can see that the type of X is actually impl future, not a result. And this gives us a clue. A future does not do anything unless it's polled. This code is constructing a future and immediately throwing it away instead of executing it. So what I actually meant to do was await on it. Now we will wait until it finishes inside this block. We can see that X has now turned into a result like we expect, but as before, we want to throw it away. So let's give this another go. I connect once from one terminal, I connect once from another terminal. There we go, it has accepted both connections in parallel. I can send data in either one and it will be handled immediately regardless of the connection order. Very good. I don't want this video to go too long, so I'm going to pause here. As you can see, it doesn't take a lot of code to handle async TCP clients, but you have to be a little bit careful not to stuff it up. In the next episodes, I'll talk about sending and receiving data line by line, handling boxed errors, and running a subprocess asynchronously. Until then, cheerio.